Yes, I am in my duvet. It is absolutely freezing in my flat tonight. I've got on two jumpers over under here. Yeah, the heating is not working and all of a sudden it seems really cold. So I've added the duvet. I'm also obviously about to get ready for bed and I was about to read a chapter of a book, so I thought Ali Smith's Autumn, just as a reminder of what we're all reading together. So we are on chapter 3. So yeah, I'll get started. Daniel is still here. The last 3 times Elizabeth's been, he's been asleep. He'll be asleep this time too when she gets here. She'll sit in the chair next to the bed and get the book out of her bag. Brave old world. He'll look like he's never going to wake up. "Hello, Mr. Gluck," she'll say if he does. "Sorry I'm late. I was having my face measured and rejected for being the wrong specification. But there's no point in thinking this. He won't. If he were to wake, the first thing he'd do is he'd tell her some fact from whichever fruitful place in his brain. It to look like the real gold rush. The local police said the tramps weren't to be paid any money by the producers till they'd all been rounded up and taken back to Sacramento City. They didn't want them going all over the district, and when he was a boy, the boy who ended life as one of the richest, most famous men in the world, when he was a boy in the poor house for children, the orphanage, when his mother was taken to the asylum, he got given a bag of sweets and an orange at Christmas time. All the kids in the place got the same. But the difference, here's the difference. He made that December bag of sweets last all the way to October. He'd shake his head. "Genius," he'd say. Then he'd squint at Elizabeth. "Oh, hello," he'd say. He'd look at the book in her hands. "What are you reading?" he'd say. Elizabeth would hold it up. "Brave New World," she'd say. "Oh, that old thing," he'd say. "It's new to me," she'd say. Okay, so we actually moved on to chapter 4 very quickly. That's the end of chapter 3. So, I'm just gonna keep reading because that was quite short. So near nothing under the covers that it hardly makes any impression, just a head by itself on a pillow, a head with a cave in it, and the cave is his mouth. His eyes are closed and watery. There's a long